Alright, let's see if this works. Alright, my name is Felipe Cortez, and this is being brought to you by That Address, and I want to thank you all for watching. If anybody's watching, we're going to run through this week and see what this week was like. We're going through something called a shutdown, a government shutdown. It's kind of a rare thing, but it happens, and what just happened right now is it looks like Graham, Schumer and Flake all decided that our military, our veterans, are the people who fight for this country are not as worthy as immigrants. Put it simply, they want to keep calling Americans like veterans deplorables while they keep calling illegals dreamers. Graham, you should stop asking for war. All those guys you're not taking care of might be a little angry. You look like an idiot. A couple of California hippies. I don't really want to call them hippies, but I'm going to be honest. I didn't grow up a hippie. I grew up very different. And I kind of heard the words never trust a hippie a whole lot. So I don't trust hippies too much. These two hippies, and they kind of look like beatniks, like they're like stuck in a different time. I don't really understand these two, but they're very creepy. And I haven't really dug too deep into their background, but they feel very much like they've been on the left for decades. And it seems like this couple of beatniks went out and found a way to torture 13 of their children till they got caught. The conditions are so weird and suspicious, it almost looks like they wanted to get caught. They just want to make everybody that's cool look bad. Not that beatniks are cool. I guess they couldn't hide that. Another big thing is that they want to release some kind of memo that was lost somewhere or hidden or... I guess somehow obscured because it would ruin the lies they've been saying against President Trump and the Russian collusion. So I'm saying release the memo. We want to know what it is. We want to know who said what. If there are any real Democrats out there in office serving the public that really are good, that care, they can prove they care about their citizens, we definitely want to know who they are. That would be a good idea. Let's release the memo. Another thing that happened this week is Dolores O'Riordan of the Cranberries was found OD'd. And when it comes to ODs and rock stars, there are so many weird and just awful endings that I'm sure if you read up on your favorite dead rock star, you could find something very suspicious in there, especially if they committed suicide. Bunch of dead rock stars die normally, but the reality is, I don't know, the timing is kind of weird, and she was on like fentanyl or whatever that fancy, whatever disgusting drug that is out there that you guys have in Europe. I don't know why you guys do that one. That one's ugly. Have you read the inserts? Have you looked at the side effects? That looks horrible. Why would you put that in your body? Whatever. All right, let's go on. She died of it. It looks like an OD. Tom Petty looks like he OD'd, but Tom Petty was on some weird combination of stuff. Prince died under suspicious... A bunch of musicians on the left have been dying odd deaths. It doesn't make sense to me. And I guess because she's punk rock, you could trace it back to punk rock in the beginning. Oh, that's the way punk rockers die. But, you know, I kind of... There's something that rubs me the wrong way about the way she died, the way Tom Petty died, the timing of it. And if you want to get into weird punk rocker deaths and suicides, they're pretty... A bunch of those are kind of weird and hard to explain. People want to leave them alone. I understand. You don't have to get involved. If I'm looking at police reports online and things are suspicious, I'm going to not have to believe them. If that means I don't talk to a bunch of people because their feelings get hurt, that's fine. I'm not going to put up with lies. If it's not making sense in my head, it's not making sense in my head. So Dolores O'Riordan, I'll miss you. I think you had a great voice. I thought you were very creative. I didn't know you were. I didn't know she was on drugs. I didn't think she was at all going through something like this. So to me, this is a big shock. She seemed like a very outgoing person that wanted to live life on her terms. That's what she seemed like. So I think this is a sad loss for rock and roll, and I wish the best for her family, and I hope that people are honest enough and strong enough to tell the truth, and because that's what we all need. Because I mean, every time I see musicians on the left OD, I think, man, who are your friends, man? You know, because that doesn't seem right. Okay. Another thing that happened this week, the former CIA member, his name is Kevin Shipp. He confirmed that President Trump has been receiving some major death threats, and that's likely because he's doing everything that he's doing now that they didn't think he'd do because they thought they'd bully him into not doing something. It didn't work out like that for them, and he's doing really good. I think he might be one of the best presidents ever. Might be comparable to Lincoln or Washington or a bunch of the other guys on that wall, on that mountain. So I definitely think that he's done well. I congratulate him. I support him. I'm praying for you still, big guy. Hang in there. Be cool. Be that cool guy, man. Tell us the truth and get it done right. Because we don't want to end up like Northern Europe. If you haven't caught up to Northern Europe, it's almost gone. It's almost lost. All those wonderful places that I wanted to visit, all that punk rock heritage that I wanted to go know firsthand and see the streets that a bunch of those pictures were taken in, and see what it's like now, and all it's pretty much gone. When every time I look at North Europe, man, it's messed up. Right now, scientists in Germany are thinking about giving the population some kind of drug to make them more acceptable of Islam and Muslims, and they've already got a TV show where where parents convert to Islam in front of their children, and they're already encouraging women to date Muslim and young girls and all that stuff, and it's like, the more I look at that, it's like, I just, the state is not all powerful. The city is not all powerful. Government is not all powerful, man. You've got to remember your heritage and the stuff that made you and kept you strong. Because what really scares Muslims in war, in combat, in fighting, is pig blood and pork. Pork steak, pork cuts, pork chops, pork meat is what they fear. So if you're having problems over there in England or in Germany or in Sweden or in Holland or in any one of those beautiful Northern European countries that I wanted to visit when I was a child or when I was a young teenager or when I was a young man, just beautiful places out there that I wanted to go see and culture that I wanted to be a part of. It's no longer an option because I really don't want to go over there and meet Mohammed. No offense, Mohammed, whoever you are. I don't want to meet you. I really, no chance. No, I'm just joking. I'm sure there's a handful of them that are really worth meeting. There's a handful of everyone that's worth meeting. The reality is that there is a bunch of countries that are training ISIS right now that are really, really, really making sure that a bunch of the soldier age men that leave the country are ready to destroy as much as possible, which is why you have acid baths in London. And speaking of which, Khan, you're an idiot. You need to get a job. You need to get out of London. London needs a new mayor. Like, having Khan, who is making excuses for gang rapists, child molesters, and acid bathers, people that bathe other people on motorcycles in acid because they're jealous of how fucking cool. I'm sorry, it's Periscope. I'm trying to be nice. But yeah, they're just trying to really make it difficult for citizens, for cool people, for people that hang out, for people that have got more going on in their lives than one simple book. Okay? Let's be real about it. They come off as jealous to me, man. Every time I look at these news reports, they come off as jealous and hateful and bullies. And I could go down the line on insults, but the reality is, what's happening out there is ridiculous. And I would love to see Northern Europe be Northern Europe again. You know, like a place that I would want to work so hard for that I'd want to go vacation over there. That's the kind of place I remember. This is like what's now. It's like, man, it's like you're telling me not to go, man. Seriously, it's kind of ugly out there. So I pray for Northern Europe. I liked a lot of those Northern European countries growing up. I thought they were cool. Okay, other things that have happened. Twitter got caught by Project Veritas saying awful things about some of the strongest supporters of Twitter, and they've admitted to saying awful things and doing awful things like spying on you and checking out your news and passing them out and all that stuff, and probably worse. Check it out, Project Veritas. It looks like the attack on President Trump through his health has finally ended. They've been trying to get rid of the president for so long on health issues. It looks stupid now because it looked stupid in the beginning, but I was paying attention to what the president was doing. He's kind of doing a lot of good. I have a few things that I have questions about, but don't we all have questions? The reality is he got cleared of his mental health and his physical health. His doctors say he's 100% okay. They don't think he needs a mental evaluation because his health is so strong. Nothing is indicating that there is some kind of imbalance. So likely there is no imbalance. That's what science has taught us. So why? Oh, why make this a bigger deal? Because they are losers who have nothing else to do. So if we keep seeing this attack on the president through the 25th Amendment, it really means that these losers have nothing left. They know it's over. They gotta pray for some asshole, sorry, for some idiot to kill him because it looks like he's unstoppable. And so long as the people are behind those ideas, what these idiots don't know is that if they kill him, those ideas get carried over. So I'm praying that he doesn't die because I remember him being a cool guy. I'm seeing him now. I put him on Plymouth Rock now, but he's a cool guy, man. He really is still that cool guy. So I really want him to do well. I want him to live. I want his family to not worry about that stuff because that's really unnecessary. These guys, they're gonna get fired. The traitors are going to get pulled out of office because they don't deserve the job. If you can't serve your community, you don't deserve to be in government. Not American government. You can go be corrupt somewhere else, although I don't advise it. But here, for sure, people are going to remember a lot more these days. So with that, I want to thank you for your time. My name is Felipe Cortez. If you want to help, you can custom order one of those beautiful guitars made by Sounds of Chaos. And I'll hook you up. I'll put links that if you want one of those, you can talk to Brian Herridor. And if not, you can help by buying one of these. And one of these comes in a pink, beautiful vinyl. This is a 2001 Stalkers 7-inch pink vinyl. So if you would like a 7-inch pink vinyl record from the Stalkers, you can get it for me. It would help out this broadcast. It would help out a lot of things going on at that address, and maybe I can still keep making these broadcasts available to all of you. If you have any questions about this is from Los Angeles, or well, it's actually from Whittier, but it's from Whittier. It's from 2001. It's real pink vinyl. It's real, you can't tell here, but it's real thick pink vinyl. It's a fairly loud pink vinyl from 2001, and if you're a child, Get your parents over here quick. Tell them to buy one of these. They'll like it more than you. It's a little raunchy. I was young once. It was fun. So I want to thank you for your help, and I want to thank you for your time, and I hope we can have more of these, all right? So thank you. Later.